What's up, everybody? Nick Guitar Swan here with you again for another lesson and tutorial on how I play solo acoustic version of Blue Sky by the Allman Brothers Band. This is probably my favorite Allman Brothers song of all time. I love Dickie Betts. His songwriting and guitar playing just resonated with me from the first time I heard him. And it's a song I never get tired of listening to or playing. It's great to play acoustic like this or electric with a full band. And I might end up doing another lesson on some of the electric licks from Dwayne Allman and Dickie Betts in that original recording of Blue Sky. Some of my favorite licks from that, but this video is for how I play Blue Sky acoustically from a video that I did back in probably 2010, 2011, I can't remember now. I was on a trip out west to Arizona. Had never been in the Southwest before, just took a solo trip out there 1 year to explore it. And I did a couple videos out there. I did one, Take It Easy by the Eagles. That was kind of just more of a snippet I cut off because somebody drove up and it kind of ruined the vibe. But I also did this song. I was sitting in kind of rush hour traffic one day around Phoenix and just thinking, man, I'm wasting my trip just sitting here in this traffic. I need to get out of this. So I just pulled off to a kind of little church that was a bit out of the way and drove up the driveway, and there was nobody up there, and it was a beautiful little spot, and just decided to play this song and film it. And honestly, like Take It Easy, I don't think I even completely knew this song correctly at that time when I played it. But I knew it well enough to jam on it. So I think the main thing that people took out of this video was kind of the way I soloed, kind of moving the chord shapes up and down the neck while keeping the bass notes going. So that's what I'm going to try to teach here. It's not going to be a note for note transcription of what I did, because I don't think I would play this the same way twice, but we'll go over the basic concepts of what I was doing. So that intro there, which in the video I think I went to the B, so but it's supposed to go to the A, so we'll start there. You're with an E power chord here, just gonna go up. So that's sliding into the fourth fret of the low E, into the second fret of the A, fourth fret of the E of the A. Then hit your A power chord. Then you're gonna come up. So you're still on the A, holding this A open, sliding up from the 4 to the 6 on the D string, then go to the G, to the 4 and 6, and then you're going to hit the open B and high E strings. And keeping on the A, just take it back down. So 6, 4, on the G string, sliding down on the D string, and then going back to the octave with the E. So. So then we're going to go up to this kind of triad. So we're at the 4th fret of the G, open B string, and the 4th fret of the high E, also keeping the low E open, muting up these two strings. Taking that down a whole step. And then just pull it off. Then you're into your D chord. So with both those D and A chords, you're pulling off. That's the intro. Then the verse and the chorus are pretty standard. There's B, A, A, B, B, A, hold it. Then we can do something like so that's just making sure you can do whatever you want there, but I went up to the G string, keeping the open A open, and these two high strings open. So go from the 4, the 6, walk it down to 4. Record, you could do something more similar to. So going down here to the 12th fret of the B and just take it down 12, 10, 9, 7, 5, then go into your A chord. Do a little sus4. You can also do something like. To lead into the chorus, so. So that's something like starting off with that E power chord and taking it up 2-4 to the octave on the D. So on the D string, 4-2, slide up to the 6, to the 4 on the G. There's any number of ways you can go about it, and that's the chorus. It's just B, A, E. You can end it on the A, or you can throw in a F sharp in the bass there. And then the whole solo is just going back and forth between the E and the A. So that's what I'm going to focus on here. Basically, what I was doing is just moving different chord shapes up and down the neck and trying to keep as many open strings going as possible. So keeping that chord progression with the bass notes down here. So just constantly make sure you're keeping the. There's a bunch of different ways you can play an E up and down the neck. So start there, and you can go down here. with A, you can go. So we're just going to kind of move it around and kind of see what I was doing back then was... Doing little things like that, and I think, like I said, the main thing you want to keep in mind is you're playing a solo guitar, so you're trying to make it as full as possible, and that means a lot of open strings. And the way to do that in standard tuning is to also make sure you're muting the strings that you're not playing. So if we come up here to this chord, we got the open E, then we mute the A and D strings, 4 on the G, open B string, 4 on the E. If we played it the other way, nobody wants to hear that. So just make sure you're muting those strings. And the same goes for when you take that kind of shape with the A. So, down here. So you got this A triad, open A, mute your D string, then 6G and 5th fret on the B and high E. Then you come up to the 7th fret on the G and the high E, mute everything else except for the open A, bring that up a whole step to the 9th fret. Then you can come down here to the E for this shape. Where you've got the third kind of in the bass, and except we have the open E going, but that's the chord without the open string, so. So you're down at 11 on the A string, and then 9th fret for the next three strings. And you can mute the high E there. So. Then you got an A shape right there. Just move your fingers a little bit down, over. Mute your low E. Get the open A. We can leave the high E open. So you got open A, 11 on the D string, 9 on the G string, 10 on the B, or you can come down, put your finger on the high E on the 9th fret. You can also use that same shape and put your pinky on the high E on the 12th fret. And that's cool to go back and forth with the E now. So that high E's acting as kind of an anchor. Or you can pull off on those other shapes in the E chord, like. So in that instance, we're not putting our ring finger down there. We're just using this ninth fret and muting the A. And taking that 10th fret of the B string on and off. So then we go down to our A shape there. We can use our pinky to take on and off from the 11th and 9th fret of the G string. Or you can go down here. Any number of ways you can do that. Then there's another cool thing you can do with the E shape. We did this in the Curtis Lowe solo. This kind of shape. It's basically would be like a E bar chord if we were all the way down there, but we're taking out all those notes. So we've just got the open low E, and then 13 on the G, 12th fret of the B, open high E. Then we can go up further to the normal A shape. We'll leave off the D string. We'll just mute that because it's a little bit easier. So open A, then A on the 14th fret of the G string. 14th fret of the B, leave the high E open. So. Even higher, you can go take the same shape and go all the way up an octave. So you're up on the 16th fret of the G and high E, still leaving your B string open and your low E open, muting everything else. Then we can do an octave for the A. So we got an open A, mute the D, 14th fret of the G, mute the B, and the 15th fret of the high E. After that, you kind of run out of neck, but you can just take it back down. So, there's a cool live version of this where at some point in the solo, I don't know if it's, can't remember if it's Dwayne or Dickey, but they do something like. So that's another cool thing you can do with this shape. When you're putting that third in the bass, that's just a really cool chord shape to do. But yeah, at a certain point, then you want to end on your high note. So we'll do like. Do a little tap and then go. Good old Sunday morning. Bells are ringing everywhere. Then you're back into it. So I hope y'all have learned something from this video and it's been helpful. Like I said, it's just mainly about you're playing E and A up and down the neck and all the different chord shapes that you can use up and down the neck. And it's good exercise to learn those if you don't know them already. And then just making sure to always keep the bass going so it sounds full. And whenever possible, keep these strings open. Or at least one of them, because that's going to help. So yeah, that's about it with that one. It was a fun one to do. Like with all of these, if I had known it was going to be viewed that much, I probably would have taken the time to learn it a little bit better before I did it. But that's part of the fun too. It's just the spontaneity of it. This was another one that got shared by Martin Guitars on their Facebook page. And they shared the Take It Easy video I did in Arizona too. I think they were trying to sell these guitars at the time. They were fairly new. And I think they did sell a good number of them. I didn't get any of that money. They did send me a t-shirt though, so that was kind of cool. I think a pack of strings as well. But yeah, it's been a popular video, and maybe I'll do another version here soon to show how I can play it more correctly at this point, or just different. There's no right or wrong. But that's it. If y'all got any more requests on a tutorial for a song or a cover that I've done in my own style, leave those in the comments. And look forward to hearing from you guys. All right.